Hi friends, in this video we are going to solve a problem based on equivalent circuit of a single phase transformer. The statement of problem is like this: a 30 kVA 2400/120 volt 50 hertz transformer, high voltage winding resistance is 0.1 ohm and leakage reactance 0.22 ohm. The low voltage winding resistance is 0.035 ohm and the leakage reactance is 0.012 ohm. Calculate for the transformer. First, equivalent resistance as referred to both primary and secondary, equivalent reactance as referred to both primary and secondary. Third, equivalent impedance as referred to both primary and secondary, and last, copper loss at full load. So let's solve. Before solving the problem, first I would like to draw equivalent circuit of a transformer with the given things. So first of all, just check whether primary is a low voltage or high voltage. So primary is the first voltage given, and first voltage is greater than the second, hence I can say primary secondary, which is N1 by N2 ratio, or you can say E1 by E2. And I can say over here high voltage winding is the primary. Why this is required? Because here they have given terms like this: high voltage winding, low voltage winding, and resistances, reactances are given. So for this purpose, let's draw equivalent circuit diagram of a transformer. So I'm writing a primary side, which is high voltage. So high voltage winding resistance is 0.1 ohm. And leakage reactance 0.22 ohm. And here high voltage is applied, 2400 volt, and secondary side I will have resistance 0.035 ohm and leakage reactance 0.012 ohm. So from this, what I can say, R1 is 0.1 ohm, X1 is 0.22 ohm, R2 is 0.035 ohm and X2 0.012 ohm. What we are supposed to do? Instead of having a two circuits like this, I should have only one circuit, either primary side, all the elements, or secondary side. That is what it is called as referred to primary and referred to secondary. So let's deal with the first part, that is equivalent resistance. So equivalent resistance referred to primary, denoted as R1E. See, here I am referring elements to the primary side, so primary resistance will remain as it is, and secondary resistance I need to refer to primary side. So for that purpose I will use a formula, R2 multiplied by, where I am referring? I am referring to the primary side, hence primary number of turns upon secondary number of turns square. And we know this is nothing but E1 by E2. So if I substitute the values given, I will get R1E equal to, R1 is 0.1 plus R2 0.035 multiplied by E1 is 2400, E2 120 square. So if you solve this, you will get R1E equal to 14.1 ohm. which is nothing but equivalent resistance referred to primary side. Similarly, I can get equivalent resistance referred to secondary. Here, referred to secondary, so R2E equal to R2 resistance will remain as it is, and R1 I am referring to the secondary. So it's N2 upon N1 square, which is nothing but R2 plus R1 multiplied by E2 upon E1 square. So R2E equal to R2 is 0.035, R1 is 0.1, E2 is 120, E1 is 2400 whole square. So, if you solve, you will get R2E equivalent resistance referred to secondary as 0.035 25 ohm. So, first part of a problem is over. Similarly, you can calculate equivalent leakage reactance referred to primary and secondary. So, equivalent reactance
referred to
primary. The formula is X1E equal to X1 plus X2 multiplied by N1 by N2 square, nothing but X1 plus X2 multiplied by E1 by E2 square. So, if I substitute the values, I will get 0.22 plus 0.012 multiplied by 2400 divided by 120 square. Solution of this equation will give you X1E equal to 5.02 ohm, which is nothing but equivalent reactance referred to primary. Similarly, I can get equivalent reactance referred to secondary. X2E, which is equal to X2 plus X1 multiplied by N2 by N1 square, nothing but X2 plus X1 E2 by E1 square. If I substitute the given values, X2E equal to 0.012 plus 0.22 multiplied by 120 divided by 2400 square. Solution of this equation will give you X2E equal to 0.01255 ohm, which is nothing but equivalent reactance referred to secondary side. This is the second part of a problem. Let's go to third part, that is equivalent impedance. So, equivalent impedance referred to primary is given as Z1E equal to root of R1E square plus X1E square. So, Z1E equal to root of 14.1 square plus 5.02 square. Solution to this equation will give you Z1E equal to 14.967 ohm. Equivalent impedance referred to primary. Same way, I can calculate equivalent impedance referred to secondary. because already we have calculated R2E and X2E. So Z2E equal to root of R2E is 0.03525 and X2E is 0.01255. If you solve using a calculator, you will get Z2E equal to 0.0374 ohm, nothing but equivalent impedance referred to secondary side. Now let's go to the last part of a problem. So let's calculate the last part, that is copper loss at full load. So copper loss is nothing but a loss because of I square R type. So I should know the full load current at the primary as well as secondary side, because we are having resistances on primary as well as secondary side. So for that purpose, the first job is to get I1FL. So how to get I1FL? It's very simple. Whatever the kVA rating is given, that need to be divided by that side voltage. So a voltage at the primary side is 2400. So this will give you I1FL as 12.5 ampere. Similarly, I can get secondary side full load current as 30,000 divided by secondary side voltage, that is 120, which is nothing but 250 ampere. Now I know I1FL and I2FL, I can get a total copper loss or copper loss at full load equal to, see here, there are two windings, primary as well as secondary. Hence, loss because of primary side resistance will be like this, and loss because of secondary side resistor will be like this. So if you substitute the values, it will be 12.5 square, and R1 is 0.1 plus I2FL is 250 and resistance is 0.035. So if you solve this, you will get copper loss equal to 2.2031 kilowatt. Now I will give you two more formula to get a copper loss. So what is the first formula? Instead of considering two circuits separately, I will consider only one circuit. So let's consider a circuit where all the elements refer to primary side. So using that, copper loss equal to primary side current square multiplied by resistance referred to primary side, that is R1E. So if I use this, it will be 12.5 square multiplied by R1E. R1E we got 14.1. So if I solve, I will get same answer, 2.2031 kilowatt. Same technique I can use if I consider circuit referred to secondary side. So if I use that, it will be secondary side full load current square multiplied by resistance referred to secondary, that is R2E. So it's a 250 square multiplied by R2E is 0.035 25. If you solve, once again you will get same answer. So depends on whatever the parameters given, use the formula to get copper loss. Thank you.